No, you're pulling my leg. I'm not joking. I saw the schedule. She's alone in the bathroom again. And she still says nothing to that old witch, Donovan.
Oh, listen to the way you talk, you naughty girl. And the answer is no. You can imagine that she doesn't dare say a thing. That silly goose lets herself be trodden on.
Oh well, at least we won't have to clean for a while.
And just wait and see the next time the water's cut off. It's a real show. Dr. Colden?
Watch out for the water, Doctor.
Hay fever. What's he doing here?
Doctor, please. My chest. Oh.
His perfusion of a semi-physiological solution doesn't seem to work. He's undergoing a ventricular fibrillation.
Nurse? Deborah, come and help me, please. His potassium level is too high. Replace it with 2% glucose solution with insulin, calcium, and sodium bicarbonate.
I'll tend to it right away.
Thank you. He's in your hands.
Ah, the whaling station.
What's wrong with me?
What are you talking about?
Doctor, is that you?
Yes, it's Dr. Colden. Tell me what happened.
It's the old whaling station. See?
The one that hides the smuggling business.
Oh, no, not them. They don't go on that side of the island. Everyone in his place. The captain on one side, Cat on the other, and me. Well, I've been to the whaling station, I have.
What did you see there?
Nothing. Nothing at all. The floor was all rotten and I fell straight through.
And that's how you broke your back?
Perhaps. No idea. Passed out.
She recently came back from the surgical block. She's stable. Given her file, a nephrectomy would have been inevitable. But Fuller was able to save her kidney. Mrs. Sanders?
What is the boiler room key doing here? The key to the boiler room. Not where I expected to find it. The key to the boiler room. Not where I expected to find it. The key to the boiler room. Not where I expected to find it.
Dr. Colden, here you are at last. This patient was again brought up to the psychiatric wing. We've been following the treatment you prescribed, but the dysgeusia persists and he's lost a great deal of weight. We haven't been able to move him. The stress makes him hyperallergic.
Sir, I am going to examine you. Do you understand? Inject him with a dose of pentobarbital, intramuscular, so that I can conduct the clinical examination. He bit his lips so much, they're still bleeding. White froth, evidently because of such drooling. His binds left bloody wounds.
So, Doctor, what should we do with this patient?
You did good work. The tranquilizer is kicked in. Now you can disinfect and bandage his wounds.
Thank you, Doctor. And as to his weight loss?
I'll prescribe an antifungal treatment for his dysgeusia. In the meantime, feed him intravenously.
It'll be done.
It's a quiet little town. Days go by, steady as ever. I wanted more for myself, but...
I don't get why they have us waiting so long. Almost no patients here.
Ethan.
Marie, I...
What are you doing here?
I'm waiting for my medication, of course. Why?
Tell me your symptoms.
I have headaches. And I can't sleep.
Do you suffer from insomnia?
No. Look, I don't want you to laugh at me.
Ethan, if you don't trust me, then who?
I have nightmares. They keep me awake every night. It seems stupid, I know, but they're terrible.
Actually, you're not the only one.
No. No one has ever seen the things I see. It's like I'm turning mad.
So many people have this affliction. It's like an epidemic.
Do you think it might be related to Fuller's work?
I don't know yet, but I will figure all this out. Everyone in Darkwater is suffering from nightmares.
Really?
We don't have any medication left.
Oh, there's no excuse then. I should let you work.
Take care, Ethan.
You too, Marie.
Where did my fiancé go? I hope those nutcases will stop burdening her with work.
Dr. Colden.
This man, Edward Pierce, his file is incomplete. What did Fuller do to him?
Dr. Colden, we need you at once in Dormitory B.
What is the problem?
Mr. Evans seems to be having trouble with his IV.
I've done an exam. Deborah is looking after him.
And the family of Mrs. Harding is asking to see her medical file.
I'll never understand why it's so hard to see patients' files around here.
Rules are rules. See, with Dr. Fuller, he's in charge. Anyhow, they're still waiting, and I don't think they'll leave until they get what they want.
Understood. Anything else?
As a matter of fact, yes. A man has been brought up from the basement.
I saw him, yes. It's always the same thing. They bring them up, without any explanation, with a multitude of self-inflicted injuries. We take care of the wounds, and then they leave. Each time, I feel like I'm sending them back to hell.
Their affliction is not our responsibility. You cannot save everybody, Doctor. Sorry, but nobody can take anything until I finish the inventory.
The operating room is never accessible after an operation. Let's hope I can go through the administration office. I don't have any business in the boiler room.
Wait a minute. Where do you think you're going? Dr. Colden.
Mrs. Donovan.
Nobody goes into Dr. Fuller's office. But rest assured, I'll tell him you came by.
That won't be necessary. Thank you.
I will tell him, nonetheless.
Elizabeth? You all right? Why is this room in such a state?
Because, as always, I'm cleaning it by myself. And the water was once again shut off this morning. I had to bother Mrs. Donovan again, giving her a new excuse to belittle me.
Do you really need Mrs. Donovan to open a valve? Why not ask the janitor?
I can't make these decisions without her approval. Imagine if there were a leak. Anyhow, the boiler room is locked half the time. So every time the water gets shut off, I have to go and endure her reproach until she's settled the problem.
I see. Courage, Elizabeth.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you. The answers must be hidden in Fuller's office. An unknown medicine. Judging by the other ones, it causes heavy side effects. Chronic insomnia, like half the island.
Dr. Colden?
There's no way I'm leaving until I find what Fuller is hiding.
Please, the fewer interruptions there are, the faster I'll be finished.
The operating room is never accessible after an operation. The operating room is never accessible after an operation. Let's hope I can go through the administration office.
Wait a minute. Where do you think you're going? Dr. Colden.
Mrs. Donovan.
Nobody goes into Dr. Fuller's office. But rest assured, I'll tell him you came by.
That won't be necessary. Thank you.
I will tell him, nonetheless.
Let's hope I can go through the administration office. Let's hope I can go through the administration office. The door to the boiler room is locked. Where did I see that key? Ah, yes. The office in Block B.
We're running out of this medicine.
I know, Doctor. We sent the purchase order, though, and Mrs. Donovan refused it.
Once again.
Can't you do anything?
Donovan takes her instructions directly from Dr. Fuller. I'm afraid I can do nothing about it for the moment.
We've been waiting to be restocked for weeks. The key to the boiler room. All I have to do is shut off the water and hope Donovan takes the bait. I can't shut this with my bare hands. I need a tool. Patients and hospital personnel eat the same food. I feel guilty about Elizabeth, but I need the diversion. Thank you.
Do you want something?
In theory, this is where we hang the key to the boiler room. Dr. Fuller always keeps his key with him. The operating room is never accessible after an operation. Let's hope I can go through the administration office. We're running out of this medicine.
I know, Doctor. We sent the purchase order, though, and Mrs. Donovan refused it.
Once again.
Can't you do anything?
Donovan takes her instructions directly from Dr. Fuller. I'm afraid I can do nothing about it for the moment. It's temperamental, if I understand correctly. It's temperamental, if I understand correctly. Thank you. The answers must be hidden in Fuller's office. It's temperamental, if I understand correctly.
Thank you.
Dr. Colden.
I'll just sleep a bit more.
Dr. Colden?
It's a quiet little town. Days go by, steady as ever. I wanted more for myself, but...
I think that you're needed in Block B, Doctor.
Dr. Colden?
Dr. Colden, might there be a problem with the water?
I was about to mention it. It seems it's been cut off yet again.
I can't take this, Marie. I feel I'm gonna burst.
It's not your fault if we have defective plumbing.
And yet, I'm the one who gets punished because I'm gonna have to square off with that annoying old witch. Courage, Elizabeth. Here we go. And hold your tongue this time.
It's temperamental, if I understand correctly.
Mrs. Donovan?
I'm busy. Elizabeth, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. But it's...
Gentlemen, may I help you?
We're waiting on news regarding our mother, Maureen Harding. She came in with a kidney problem, but we haven't heard anything since.
I've tended to her, and I have good news. Her blood analysis is reassuring. Her kidneys are as new.
Are you talking about the same person? This is miraculous.
She's still recovering, but you may speak to her upon her awakening.
Oh, thank you so much, Doctor. We'll wait for her to wake up. We've been here since this morning, so it won't make a difference. Thank you again, Doctor.
Let's hope I can go through the administration office. last. The missing files must be hidden here. The Stendhal syndrome. Of course. This is where Fuller found his diagnosis for Francis Sanders. I should go another way. Something is wrong with these masts. It's some sort of puzzle. I've unlocked something. Patient files. I was right.
Conclusions. Session number 17. Patient. Sarah Hawkins. The patient appears to have finally accepted the illusory nature of what she calls the mythos. It goes without saying that these peculiar delusions are the price that comes with her exceptional gifts.
Why does Dr. Fuller write psychological reports about Sarah Hawkins?
At first, I presumed that her blood was the key. But I found nothing to explain Mrs. Hawkins' abilities.
Poor souls downstairs are not Fuller's only subjects.
Then James came. Irate that Charles was keeping secrets from him. I presume that he will try to break into the basement sooner or later. I am prepared.
Hawkins, Fitzroy, and Fuller. What is the connection between these three?
It's definite that I had the presence of mind to set the morgue in the basement. When all the fuss about the Hawkins incident finally comes to an end, I will dispose of her belongings. In the meantime, they must remain hidden in plain sight.
Of course. Sarah Hawkins is the connection. I must go back to the basement.
Now, that's the Marie that I know. I knew I could count on your scientific curiosity. It's time to show you what you were so eager to discover.
If you're gonna shoot me, at least have the decency to look me in the eyes.
Turn around. Slowly. Talk, filthy thief! Or I swear I'll shoot!
Take a minute to look around. Everything points to Charles Hawkins.
He's dead!
No. He was here for a very specific item.
Oh, no.
The book. Why was it in the safe?
Have you read it?
Answer the question.
How foolish of you. Now you won't be able to escape his will. What did it show you?
She went into Fuller's office. She was looking for Sarah Hawkins' corpse.
Sarah Hawkins, you say? Let's go back to the start, shall we? Whose life did the Necronomicon choose to show you?
Dr. Colden. She was at the Riverside Institute. She's in danger. I have to go.
Wait! No one knows the occult better than me. You might need my help.
All right. I might need you after all.
Perfect. Let's meet later at the Hawkins Mansion. Now go! Rescue the doctor!
Thank you, Drake. I pray that Colden is really here and alive. Old diary. What the... Fuller, too. Right. Enough time wasted. Colden needs me. I must find her.
I wanted to see him about something. Best thing. You know
I'll go take a look. See you there.
I pray that Colden is really here and alive. An old diary. What the... Fuller, too. Right. Enough time wasted. Colden needs me. I must find her.
Best thing. You know how he hates to be interrupted.
God, what is happening to me?
What was that? It's as if I'd been transported somewhere else.
Thank you.
I've seen this symbol.